Yeah, David, there are still many frustrated passengers, and of course, rebooking is always hectic. But as of now, air travel is mostly back to normal. Of course, when any time you get this many cancellations and delays in a 24-hour period, things are going to be a little bit sticky and difficult when people have to find secondary plans moving forward. Now, we spoke with travelers as well who told us they are going to miss weddings. They're going to miss birthdays, the birth of new family members. Some were planning to take red-eye flights out last night, only that to then stay at the airport overnight, hoping for the next available plane out, those ripple effects I was referring to earlier. American, Delta, United, and Frontier were some of the airlines most affected by the CrowdStrike outage. Even some of the PDX websites and some of the gate computers didn't work earlier this morning. One flyer, UK RIA, said there was a rush for people to find new flights out, but not enough flights for everyone.
Then you came downstairs, stay in this long line, get in there, they said there is nothing. My brother's daughter is wedding, and I have some wedding stuff here. I have cried my eyes out since morning. I've cried my eyes out.
For the most part, most people have found something else to rebook or another solution moving forward, but there are still some people waiting around for that next opportunity. And when it comes to the cancellations and delays, as of last count, there were close to 100 delayed or canceled flights arriving at PDX since last night, the start of this outage, and about 60 canceled or delayed flights leaving PDX. David.